I want to thank you for joining us to celebrate our students and their success. And in a short time, I'm going to introduce you to the graduating class of 2021. While we're waiting for our graduates, I'd like for you to please turn your attention to the screen and please enjoy Satterton Vantage Academy's reading of Amanda Gorman's poem, The Hill We Climb. If you remember watching the inauguration this year, I know that it was one of the highlights of the inauguration for me. I was blown away by Amanda Gorman and her poem, as were many of us. And so this features Vantage staff and students, including two of our seniors.
When day comes,
we ask ourselves,
where can we find a light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We braved the belly of the beast.
We've learned that quiet isn't always peace, and the norms and notions of what just is isn't always justice.
And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished.
We, the successors of a country, in a time where a skinny black girl, descended from slaves and raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president, only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect.
We are striving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man.
And so we lift our gaze, not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first, we must first put our differences aside.
We lay down our arms so that we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true, that even as we grieved, we grew, that even as we hurt, we hoped, that even as we tired, we tried.
That we'll forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid.
If we're to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but in all the bridges we've made. That is the promise to glade, the hill we climb, if only we dare.
It's because being American is more than the pride we inherit. It's about the past we step into and how we repair it.
We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it. It would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy, and this effort nearly succeeded.
But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith we trust. For while we have our eyes on the future, history has his eyes on us.
This is an era of just redemption. We feared at its inception. We do not feel prepared by to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour. But within it, we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So while once we asked, how could we possibly prevail over catastrophe, now we assert, how could catastrophe possibly prevail over us?
We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be. A country that is bruised but whole, benevolent but bold, fierce and free.
We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens.
But one thing is certain. If we merge mercy and might with right, then love becomes our legacy, and change our children's birthright.
So let us leave behind a country better than the one we were left.
Every breath from my bronze-pounded chest, we will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one.
We will rise from the golden hills of the West. We will rise from the windswept Northeast where our forefathers first realized revolution. We will rise from the lake-rimmed cities of the Midwestern states. We will rise from the sun-baked South.
We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover. And every known nook of our nation and every corner called our country, our people diverse and beautiful, will emerge.
Battered and beautiful.
When day comes, we step out of the shade of flame and unafraid. The new dawn balloons as we free it. For there is always light, if only we're brave enough.
Brave enough.
Brave enough.
To see it.
If only we're brave enough.
Brave enough.
Brave enough.
To be it.
Well, thank you. And thank you to the students and staff that participated. That was awesome. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've been waiting for. The graduating class of 2021. Choked up there. And it's funny, the next thing I'm going to say, and you know, I think you can cry when you feel joy, right? But today I feel joy, not just happy, not just the kind of happy that I feel when it's good weather, not the kind of happy that I feel when, you know, the traffic wasn't too bad, okay? But joy, the kind of joy that even through tough times, even though times might be tough, I just know in my heart that everything's going to be okay. Have you ever felt that way? Every person in this room has a story of what they've been through this past year, of the difficult times, of the good times. All of us have learned this past year to appreciate things that we used to take for granted, right? Like not wearing a mask, okay? Going to restaurants when we want to, and being able to sit inside. Wow. And going to the movies, which I do miss. But most of all, we realize how much we miss being in a community of people and spending times with those that we love. Well, there's a lot of people in this room that I love and respect, and I feel joy. Graduates, all of you have a story too. Your individual journeys through childhood to make it to your high school graduation today. There were tears, obstacles, and hard times along the way. Some of you just recently told me that you never thought that you'd make it to graduation, but here you are. Do you know, I just read, and this is kind of sad, and I think it's even worse this year, that 1.2 million young people drop out of high school every year. That's a lot higher than I thought, and I think it's higher this year. But guess what? Today, you are not part of that group. You are among the successful. All of you have unique gifts and talents that can make a positive impact in our world. And today, your parents, family, and friends are all very proud of you. Now I would like to introduce to you a parent who will speak about her thoughts and experiences from this past year. Lindsay Patton will come and speak. Lindsay is the mom of Matt Benner. Matt Benner will be a senior next year as he transitions to North Penn High School. Lindsay?
I just want to say, please forgive me if I clear my throat a lot or I have to grab my water. I'm also a teacher, and yesterday was our red and gold day, and today is our red and gold. We're having it all week. It's like your field day. And I have been using my voice a lot. And then this morning, I had a kindergarten orientation, so I was jumping around with kindergartners and dancing and using my voice a lot, so I apologize. I realized halfway through with my kindergartner, I started losing my voice. So, as I was introduced, hello, my name is Lindsay Patton. I am Matthew Benner's mom. I've been asked to speak to you all today. First of all, I would like to say congratulations to the graduating seniors. These are exciting times as you start the next chapter of your life. So kudos to you all. So why am I talking to you? Well, it's a pretty good question. I want to explain why and what brought Matt to Vantage Academy and how his experience has helped him to grow and succeed. So I guess it's always best to start at the beginning. And I can see Matt over there waiting to see how badly I embarrass him, as now he has put his head down. Matt was diagnosed with ADHD by his neurologist in kindergarten. Due to his impulsivity, school became a challenge and a hated place for him. Matt is incredibly intelligent, and he figured out ways to, shall I say, cheat the system. In other words, he knew what to do in order to have his elementary school call me every day and come and get him. Now, I could talk on and go into every little detail, but we would be here forever, so let's just go with the cliff notes, shall we? From second grade until partway through ninth grade, right before Matt came to Vantage, it was a roller coaster for us all, but especially Matthew. Along with his ADHD diagnosis, Matt was also diagnosed with major depressive disorder, anxiety, and autism. He's been in and out of partial programs, the Horsham Clinic and the Light Program. He and I spent a week in CHOPS ICU due to an overdose, as well as other self-harming behaviors. He also spent time as an inpatient at Brooklyn Behavioral Hospital. It was becoming acutely clear that his school district could not provide the services he desperately needed to succeed at school. Once the decision was made to transition Matt to a new school, we started looking around. When we visited Vantage, I was so impressed with the program. Matt loved the small class sizes, the block scheduling, and of course, Abigail. We knew this would be a good fit for him. Remember when I said Matt was good at figuring out ways to cheat the system? He tried it here, but it didn't work so well. Why, you ask? Because the faculty here didn't give up on him. He was used to people doing that, giving up on him, as he had given up on himself. It didn't happen. Matt could push, pull, try whatever he wanted, but you, the faculty, didn't give up. The school helped him to see all the potential and his abilities his family always knew he had. He went from a below average student at North Penn to making honor roll here several times over. And in the fall, Matt will be back at North Penn full time for his senior year. This was his choice. This past weekend, I was talking with my dad about trying to figure out what I was going to say. And I was telling him how I was speaking today. And I always bounce things off of him as he is my hero, and he's also been a lifelong educator. He said to me when he thinks about Matt's situation and how far he has worked to overcome his issues and succeed as he has, he is in awe of Matthew. I said the same as well. I'm in awe of Matthew and how hard he has worked. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge Kathy. Thank you for your constant faith in and support of Matt. You never gave up on him. You beat down his walls, and it's not easy, and he challenges. I have two favorite memories of Matt here at Vantage. The picture you sent me of him and Abigail when he put his sunglasses on Abigail. That is a favorite of mine. And the video you sent me last week. I loved seeing the PE teacher dancing around when Matt was playing the guitar. I thought that was great. And in fact, I shared that video with all the faculty members at my school because at the end of the year, teachers all need something to smile about. So that made my heart happy. As I end here, I would like to thank everyone at Vantage again. Your dedication to all of your students is unparalleled. While there will be bumps in Matt's paths as he continues forward, I have no doubt about it. We all hit potholes, sharp curves, screws in tires. I say that because I actually had a screw in my tire yesterday and had to go get it fixed. But the tools you have given him will help him navigate his way. Thank you all for making him smile more, work hard, but most importantly, enjoy life and want to live again. For this and so much more, I am forever grateful. I would like to end with this quote, as I think it fits well for what Vantage stands for. And seniors, I also give this quote to you as well. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. I hope you always find the courage to continue. Thank you all.
Lindsay, thank you for sharing. It's difficult to follow up on that, but we appreciate you sharing your story and how powerful it is, and congratulations again to Matt and all that you've accomplished. Good afternoon. If you don't know me, my name is Jesse Walsh, and I'm the Director of Educational Services at Souderton Vantage. It's my honor to greet you all this afternoon on behalf of our staff and our students. So we're very excited to highlight some of our students who've distinguished themselves over the past year. But before we do so, I'd like to take a couple moments to stand on the soapbox and give some comments to our staff, to our students, families, and especially to our seniors. So please indulge me for a moment or two. Graduations, we hear often about the past. We talk a lot about hope for the future. But I'd like to talk about the present for a moment. What kind of person do you want to be today? 7 years ago, on Halloween, I was sitting at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia with my oldest son, Josiah, waiting on a blood transfusion for him. Josiah was diagnosed in September with very severe aplastic anemia, an extremely rare life-threatening illness that turned our lives upside down overnight and that led to over 2 years of treatment for him. At that time, we weren't sure what was going to happen with Josiah, what the outcome of his disease would be. There was no guarantee that Josiah would be able to recover from it. We were at CHOP two or three times a week, often in the oncology floor with kids who were sick with cancer, who had to get hemoglobin and platelet transfusions on a regular basis. As we sat there that Halloween, and we were waiting for him to finish his treatment, a woman and two small children entered behind the curtain, said trick or treat, and asked Josiah if he wanted some candy. Now, to some, that might be a small, insignificant act of kindness, but at that moment, that was huge to me and to Josiah. This person could have been anywhere on Halloween celebrating the day with her children, but instead she chose to be with my kid on the oncology floor who couldn't go trick-or-treating that night because he needed a blood transfusion to stay alive. It might be exciting, seniors, or it might be terrifying, or it might be both, for you to think about what comes next. But the truth is, regardless of what you choose to do after graduation, the fact is who you are as a person, that's what follows you wherever you go. My message today to myself and everyone here and to you seniors is be the kind of person that makes other people feel better around you. Perseverance, character, hope. These are the defining values of Souderton Advantage. And we haven't talked much about them in the past couple years, but we've certainly seen these values lived out amongst our staff and amongst our students and our families. This is what I think makes Vantage so unique as a school, as a community. The desire to be a place that makes others want to press on through the difficult times when they want to give up. To know there's a place where there are people you can depend on to care about you on your worst day, and that will celebrate you on your best day. To believe there is hope. I often talk to my own kids about how there are some things in life that you just don't have control over. And I think we've all realized over the past year what that means. It's the things that happen to you that you have no say over that really challenge us as human beings to persevere and to still believe there's some good in the world. We've all been affected in some way like this through the pandemic, and some of us are still feeling those effects. Many of us are. But then there are the things that we do have control over, even in the midst of the trauma. We get to choose what we do with what we're given. We can allow those experiences to make us bitter, to make us angry, to make us spiteful, or we can allow those same experiences to make us empathetic, to make us compassionate, to make us understanding. The anonymous mom at CHOP, she chose the latter. And it gave Josiah and I enough hope to persevere through that day. That is in fact what the students are about. I'm sorry, that is in fact what the students we are about to honor in a couple of minutes did this past year. They persevered through difficult times. They chose to allow their experiences to make them even stronger people. And yet they didn't keep that strength to themselves. They took that strength and they shared it with others around them to give them hope. That being said, it's now time to present the Student of the Year, the Most Improved Student of the Year, and the Transition Student of the Year Awards. Each of these awards honors a student who experienced significant growth, not only as a student, but as a person. They set the standard for what it looks like to be the kind of student that not only succeeds themselves, but allows that success to benefit those around them. So at this time, I'm going to ask some of our counselors to come up and present these awards. First, Desmond Decker is going to come up and present the Most Improved Student of the Year Award, and he'll be followed by Kathy DeSanctis-Moyer, who will announce the Transition Student of the Year, and then last but not least, our Student of the Year Award. Desmond?
Hello, everybody. So first things first, you know, huge congratulations to you guys, senior class. You know, as Jesse said, you showed persistence, you showed resilience through a rough year that I think a lot of people here would have had the same amount of struggles, you know, if it had been us, our senior year. So big congratulations to you guys. I think I can speak for everybody at Vantage in saying that, you know, we're extremely proud of you guys. So well done. So today, I'll be presenting the award for Most Improved Student of the Year. In my first few months at Souderton Vantage in the fall of 2018, this student was transferred to my caseload after being in our fifth and sixth grade VIA program. In the seventh grade, he struggled in a few areas of school, including work refusal, impulsive behavior, and the habit of making small issues throughout the day into much bigger issues. Many days were spent talking with him about the frustrations of the classroom and stressors that would arise as the year went on. Early on, it was not uncommon for these conversations to occur multiple times a day and on occasion hours at a time. As his eighth grade year approached, I was curious if the same behaviors and patterns would continue. They did, however, with much less consistency and to much less of the extent of the year before. Work refusal continued, but at a much lower rate, and I saw big improvements in his ability to process through and handle stressful or uncomfortable situations. In March of 2020, when all schools were shut down and forced to go to a virtual schedule, many students didn't do well with completing their work, but our 2020-2021 most improved student was on the other end of that spectrum and did a great job doing his work online and working well throughout the year. His positive momentum carried through to this year in the first semester, where he continued to be virtual until this last January. Where I personally thought that this student really earned the title of most improved was in his return to in-person schooling in January. I was nervous of how he would do with returning to the classroom. Expectations were higher than they'd been for him for almost a year, and classroom distractions were a concern to me as well. Sorry, I lost my spot. My nerves quickly went away after the first week he was in person. He was using skills that had only been spoken about before, and when he was sent to the resolve room, he was quick to discuss and work through issues like the high school student that he now is. Academically, he improved his grades to C's and D's through middle school to now all A's and B's in his second semester of high school, of his first year of high school. I've been very proud to see his growth over the last 3 years, and especially in the 2020-2021 school year. I also have to give credit to his parents for their communication and help over the last 3 years. They've been a pleasure to work with, and they've had a huge impact on the successes that I've spoke about. Next year, this student will be attending Souderton Vantage for a half day, but will also be attending North Montco Technical Career Center for their HVAC program. He will then be transitioning eventually back to Souderton High School and leaving our program. I will be sad to see him less and less over the next year. However, I am very excited to see him move back to an environment where he can take advantage of opportunities that Souderton High School and the tech school will provide him. He's exemplified what our hopes are for students attending Souderton Vantage, and I could not be more proud of his accomplishments and growth this year. I'm very excited to see him mature more and more by the year as he moves through high school, and he has more than earned the title of Most Improved Student this year. So Souderton Vantage's Most Improved Student of the Year is Jason Zamblack. Come on up.
My name is Kathy DeSanctis-Moyer, and I am one of the counselors here, and it's great to be here this afternoon. I have the privilege to present two awards today, and the first one is for Transition Student of the Year. This award is for a student who spends a partial day at Vantage and another part of the day either at their home school or a tech school. And this student is highly successful in both. So in describing this student, I will be using several references to Pink Floyd music. Thank you, Tim Eager, for helping me. I could not have done this without your assistance. Okay. If you walk down the hallways at Vantage, you can often hear the laughter of this student. But when the student first started, you could say his affect was on the dark side of the moon. Okay, first reference. Did you catch it? Okay, thank you. Okay. He struggled with adapting to school and often did not know how to truly be himself. But little by little, he's been adding bricks to his wall. Okay, good. Thanks. That's great. Building up courage to face challenges and head on. Academically bright, he also realized that he did indeed need an education. Okay. Actually, he thrives on learning and wanted to pursue returning to his home school. So this award recipient spent his mornings taking classes at North Penn High School and finished up his afternoon with classes at Souderton Vantage. Successful in both, he earned an honor roll. He is an accomplished drummer and a self-taught guitar player. He is computer savvy, and yes, he does love Pink Floyd. Do you know what I'm talking about, right?
You didn't make it obvious enough.
Okay, thanks, Brandon. Matt Benner. So, oh, come on up, Matt. Come on up, Matt. I'm not done talking about you yet, so come stand here, just real quick, okay? So we just want to say great job at both schools this year, and we will miss you next year. So proud of you to be able to go to North Penn High School full time. And the last thing is, as you reflect on your experience, I'm sure you will tell your friends that it's been the happiest days of our lives.
Oh.
Hey, good job.
Shine on your face. Oh.
I tried. Okay. Oh, boy. I don't listen to Pink Floyd, but can you tell? Okay, now for the second award, and this one is for the Student of the Year. So we all need a little sunshine in our lives, right? Presenting this award for the Student of the Year is truly a sunny spot and a highlight, especially in this crazy COVID world we have all experienced. This award recipient is a student who is respected and relied upon by staff. She is a young lady who puts her best effort forward every single day. When thinking about this student, you may be tempted to have thoughts like this. Oh, it just comes easy to her. She's smart. She doesn't have problems. Well, school has not been an easy journey for her. There are times she did not want to attend school at all and actually missed a ton of school due to feeling overwhelmed by academics and other students at her home school. When she first arrived at Vantage in 2017, she was super nervous about her school, yet she arrived with a small ray of hope that just maybe she could give it a try and see, could this school work for me? Over time, she realized that Souderton Vantage Academy was a safe place for her. Smiles emerged on her face. She began to laugh at Darren's dad jokes, enjoy the creativity in English class, and love on Abigail. And in this zone of safety and true caring, this rewarded recipient has emerged as a strong young lady. Certainly, she has done very well at Vantage. Every day, whether virtual, in person, or online hybrid, whatever the case, she has worked hard to learn, and she does homework. That's amazing. The other thing that she has done is really connected in counseling and worked on her issues and the big questions that teenagers ask themselves, which are like, who am I and where am I going? What am I doing with my life? She is a kind-hearted person and demonstrates a mild-mannered confidence as she expresses herself and loves for her animals and K-pop. If you haven't guessed yet, I am talking about Rebecca Schweitzerhoff, and she's our only G3 student, which is the level of leadership. And Rebecca also started the Sunshine Club at Vantage Academy, which is why my reference to Sunshine connected that there. Today we celebrate you, Rebecca, so can you come on up? Here you are, Student of the Year, Rebecca. Thank you.
Thank you, Desmond. Thank you, Kathy. And congratulations to our award winners. We're so proud of you. Well, the moment you've been waiting for. Okay, and by the way, you all look great. Graduates, obtaining a high school diploma is one of the greatest accomplishments an individual can earn. I congratulate all of you for a job well done. I also want to congratulate your parents, and I want to thank them for allowing us to be part of their team in helping you experience success. How about a round of applause for our parents? I also want to have a special thanks to Brenda Lopez, who has provided each table with graduation cookies. Thank you, Brenda. Woo! Please be sure to take one home with you when you leave today. And now I will read the name of the graduates. Graduates, when I call your name, please come forward to be honored. Sky Bizanis. Matthew Drayton. Nenfis Gonzalez Hernandez. Luca Kalb. Christian Landis. Brandon Pacheco. Alexa Williamson. Graduates, please move your tassel from the right side to the left side. And ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduating class of 2021. I want to thank you again for coming. Please come forward to hug and greet our graduates and have a wonderful afternoon. Thank you.